Rough flight is raising new concerns tonight about the safety of air travel. And Paul, dozens were hurt when Continental Flight 128 hit severe turbulence.
That's right, Jessica. And you know, now forecasters can't seem to agree on whether skies were stormy or calm at the time. But either way, the incident is forcing air officials to take a closer look at a phenomenon known as clear air turbulence.
I thought it was normal turbulence until I saw everyone pop out of their seats and then I thought we were going to die.
Oklahoman Ryan Morgan was on board Continental Flight 128 when suddenly the plane started shaking.
Came out of their chairs and some people chipped pieces of the ceiling of the tiles off and other people, their head completely went through.
Anyone not wearing a seatbelt was thrown about the cabin. Officials say the plane likely hit clear air turbulence, which happens at high altitudes in calm conditions.
But this sort of thing usually is at night and usually involves suddenly hitting a rising column of air that the crew had no way of seeing.
So, what exactly is clear air turbulence?
Clear air turbulence is when you look at the atmosphere like a sandwich, and the top layer of the sandwich is going a lot faster than the ground layer. Now,
when a plane is caught in a thunderstorm, the air comes straight up and down. But with clear air turbulence, the air rotates.
It's like hitting a speed bump at 500 miles an hour.
And it's pretty unpredictable. Right now, pilots can use this clear air turbulence map. The risk for rough air goes from none to extreme. Today, a patch of air just north of Oklahoma is a moderate to severe risk. The best way to protect yourself? Buckle up.
It's your own self-interest. You need to keep those belts fastened.
Right now, the FAA, NASA, and private companies are trying to develop turbulence warning technology that could be used by pilots in flight.
And if you want to check the clear air turbulence map before your next flight, we have the link at KOCO.com.